I think there's a global economic recovery, which looks actually rather more sustainable than the US recovery. Most of the US recovery is in the form of stimulus from government, the Cash for Clunkers program and the encouragement to first-time home buyers. That accounted for a really large percentage, more
Less
than half.
Less than 50.
Pretty close to half if you add those two things together, and then the rest of it has to do with inventories. I don't think this is a sustainable recovery yet. The recession is technically over, but I will be very surprised if the next quarter's numbers are as good, because these programs are expiring or have expired. The global recovery is more interesting because China, and not only China, also India and Brazil, plus a whole bunch of other mainly Asian economies, are growing much faster than I think anybody would have predicted 6 months ago. Not many people back in the dark days of the spring thought that even China would bounce back this strongly. But with growth now at an annual rate of around 10%, and interestingly, consumer growth in China growing even faster than that, there is clearly a global recovery. But the engine of growth is not the United States. For the first time, and one might say in a century, the engine of growth in the world economy is no longer the United States.
But it hasn't been the United States for a number of years.
No, the engine of growth in the world economy was China plus the United States in the last 10 years. But it was very much China plus the United States. You can actually figure this out if you look at the decade running up to the crisis, so 1998 to 2007, two-fifths of total growth in the world economy was China plus America. But of that two-fifths, the United States was the lion's share, just because it's still the biggest economy in the world.
And how much of it has to do with the Chinese stimulus?
A lot, because that, in relative terms, is a very, very big shot in the arm of China's economy. Plus, China's stimulus has kind of worked better. It turns out that you can have Keynesian policies.
The way it is with a command economy.
Well, yeah, right. You can have Keynesian policies where you aim to stimulate demand through massive government expenditure financed by borrowing more easily in a controlled economy than in an open economy like that of the United States, which is a point, incidentally, that Keynes made in the 1930s. If you look at the foreword to The General Theory, the 1936 classic, in the German edition, Keynes says that the policies he recommends of deficit-financed government pump priming will work better in a controlled totalitarian economy than in a free, open economy, and that's still true today.